Zimmerman's attorney has filed a motion to allow him to appear at his bond hearing on Friday without shackles and in his own clothes.
And prosecutors have just released even more discovery evidence from the case. West News' Amanda Ober is tracking all the new information coming into our newsroom. She joins us live right now with more. Amanda.
Only one new item of evidence was released today, and it involved a reenactment. It was a recording of George Zimmerman being cued by an investigator to yell out, "Help!" It was recorded over a telephone line, so it would be similar to the 911 calls made the night of the Trayvon Martin shooting.
Ever since the release of the 911 calls in the Trayvon Martin shooting, there's been much debate over who is heard in the background yelling for help, George Zimmerman or Trayvon Martin.
911, do you need police, fire, medical?
Today, the prosecutor released a recording of two voice samples George Zimmerman provided back in late March. You hear an investigator call a dispatcher at the sheriff's office and ask them to make the recording.
We're getting ready to do it, and basically, we're just going to have the gentleman reenacting a few things. You'll hear some yelling and things like that.
Yes.
But you know, no need to interrogate us or the call or anything.
Exactly.
We're doing it for recording purposes.
Exactly.
Large sections of the recording are silent, but you do hear Zimmerman yell "help" almost two dozen times and then yell "help me" 17 times. At Zimmerman's original bond hearing, testimony revealed FBI experts did analyze the background cries heard on one of the 911 calls and concluded it was impossible to tell whose voice it was. Meantime, Zimmerman is preparing for another bond hearing Friday. In a motion just filed, his attorney, Mark O'Mara, asked the judge to allow Zimmerman to wear street clothes and no shackles. O'Mara writes, "The manner in which Mr. Zimmerman is portrayed by the media will have a tremendous impact on his ability to receive a fair trial."
At his last bond hearing, Zimmerman's attorney made that same request of the judge. Zimmerman was allowed to wear a suit as opposed to a prison jumpsuit, but his hands were cuffed to a chain around his waist and his ankles shackled. Amanda Ober reporting, West 2 News.